Hi everyone, this is Dom Designs here and welcome back to today's tutorial. Today, I will teach you how to draw this cute looking peach as a flat design vector in Adobe Illustrator. If it's your first time on my channel and you're interested in learning how to create logos, icons, and illustrations in Adobe Illustrator, then please consider subscribing to the channel and hit that bell icon so you never miss an upload. As always, I like to plan my illustrations on paper before working on the program itself. I try to get as close as possible to the final render by adding details and shadows to the sketch. Once the sketch is completed, you can take a picture of it with your phone and transfer it to your desktop. Alright, so I imported my sketch on a 1920 by 1080p canvas in Illustrator. You can place any image on your canvas by doing Command plus Shift plus P on your keyboard. You can then center it and turn it into a template. Once we have our template layer, let's begin by creating the outlines on a new layer which I will name Outline. Let's begin by tracing out the leaves using the pen tool. You'll see me overlap the shapes of the leaves. I do this so I can create two separate closed shapes. What I will do is select both shapes and bring up the Shape Builder tool, which is Shift M on your keyboard. I'll then click on the area of the back of the leaf to create a new shape. Then you can just delete the unwanted shape in the middle. Since the peach I sketched is very circular, I will use the ellipse tool to create most of its outline. So let's create a circle which aligns with the left part of the peach, like so. We will then bring up the pen tool and click on the stroke to create new points at the top and at the bottom. Once we have those in place, we can delete the points on the right to create a semicircle like so. To delete the points on the circle, you will need to bring up the white arrow tool, which is A on your keyboard. Let's repeat this step on the right side of the peach. Alright, so as you can see, our stroke has overlapped over the leaf part. That's not a problem because the Shape Builder tool can fix this for us. Let's select the leaf and the stroke and bring up the Shape Builder tool. And then, all you have to do is to carefully option click on the stroke in the leaf to delete it. Perfect, now let's finish tracing our sketch. Since I sometimes struggle creating smooth lines with the pen tool, what I do is create a straight line and then manually curve it using the curvature tool. I find that our outline is a little thin, so I will select all and bring up the stroke thickness to about 11 points. Awesome! We have one final step before we begin our coloring process. I would like to vary the thickness of the strokes to give our illustration a more appealing look. So for that, let's bring up the Width tool. You can then click and drag to vary the weights of our strokes. I like to taper off the ends like so. And we are finally done our outlining process. Now's the time to add our colors. For starters, I'll create a new layer below the outline and name it color. This ensures that when working with colors, we do not affect the outline. Let's start with the easy part and add the base color to the leaves. Since these were created as closed shapes, we can select them from our outline layer. We can then go down to the layer panel, and while holding Option on your keyboard, you can copy over the little red square down to the color layer. All we did is copy over an exact replica onto our new layer. Now all we have to do is invert the stroke to fill and change the color to a bright green. Finally, we will add the remaining base colors by retracing our outline on the color layer with a color fill. All the colors being used in this illustration are available in the description below. But if you're interested in purchasing my personal coloring palette, then head over to my Etsy shop link in the description. Now, usually peaches have a yellowish hue to it as well. So let's add a gradient going from yellow to our peach orange. Also, make sure that your gradient is set to radial. Beautiful! I love how the gradient just makes the illustration stand out. Now let's add some shadows and highlights to the illustration. With the pen tool, I'll draw the shadows with a dark orange color. I will then bring down the opacity to about 60%. All we're missing now are the highlights. Following the same method of the shadows we just created, I'll add a highlight going along the right side of our peach. I'll give it a soft yellow, which I'll dim down its opacity as well. As you can see, I drew the shape going outside of our illustration. I did that so that I can just delete the overlapping shape using the Shape Builder tool. All you have to do is Option click on the excess shape to delete it. This saves me from having to do extra pen tool work. Let's finish off the illustration by adding the remaining shadows and highlights. And there you have it. This is how you draw a peach in Adobe Illustrator. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please leave a like and let me know your opinion in the comments below. See you in the next video, everyone. Cheers.